everybody, including divine spirits, and the god makes mistakes in this mythology, and of course the gods made a primary error. Instead of leaving the elves and men to fight out their way under the guidance of God, they invited the elves, because the rebel amongst them, the wicked god Melkor, was alive, was a devastated last part of the world. They took them back into their paradise to the west to protect them. And so that the whole machinery starts from the rebellion of the elves, and their fall in rebellion of the evil they did in their bursting out from paradise. So what you've got in the, in our period is two lots of elves, ones that, that never started, just didn't want to be bothered to be anything higher than they were the ordinary woodland elves of the far east. Those who started to go to the divine paradise and never got there, which are the grey elves of the west, and those who got and came back as exiled. The high elves who sing this the song to Elbereth in the beginning of the Lord of the Rings are exiled elves, who'd once known what it was to see the demiurgic gods in person. Now dwarves create how difficult, don't they, in this particular thing. They have certain grievances against men and against elves. They are incarnate in bodies rather like ourselves. We don't know much about them, but they apparently are mortal, though they are longevable. Where do they come into the scheme? Well, of course, you get a great deal of thought to revive their origin. I don't think I'll say anything about it at the moment, but they have a rational origin related to that theme, but they're not part of the children of God.
Yeah, that
that's all I can really say about this. Men are just men.